Blended box map is a great addition to the 3ds Max arsenal. However, it cannot completely replace other mapping techniques. While it works great with static objects, this map can be somewhat limited with animated assets. This is because of the way blended box map works, which is literally like a movie projector. Unlike UV unwrapping, which is baked onto the model, blended box map can create mapping shifts when the object moves or deforms. Here's a simple situation that is easy to understand. Create a simple box. Make it about 25 by 25 by 70 in size, but make sure it has a few height segments for more detail. Apply some deformable modifiers to it, such as taper, twist, and bend. Animate these modifiers between frames 0 and 100. Go back to frame 0, where the box is clearly standing up as originally modeled. Create a standard material with a blended box map applied to its diffuse channel. For good measure, use the checker patterns to better study the effects. Set the projection to cubic, uniform, with a size of about 8. At frame 0, the render shows that each face of the box is rendered with the proper projection bitmap, as anticipated. A render at frame 100, however, shows that the mapping does not follow the deformation. Although the effect can be cool, the reality is that this technique may be useless in certain scenarios if applied to an animated character, for example. As far as animation is concerned, the limitations mostly concern deformable models, such as characters skinned to bone skeletons. Models such as cars or airplanes that do not deform but simply travel and rotate can still be textured with blended box map. Let's test it out. Open the scene named BBM Animated Car Start.max. It shows a sports car animated to take a sharp left-hander. The tail of the car is slightly skidding in the process. Make sure you are at frame 0 and render the perspective view. You may want to zoom in on the car first. A blended box map is already in use on the car material. It is also using a dummy object to project maps conforming to the car shape. You still need to add the actual bitmaps, though. You can use the load maps feature, but what's interesting in this case is that we only have 4 maps instead of 6. Textures 2 and 6, representing the bottom and the back projections, have not been planned. If you tried using existing maps in multiple channels, such as the front map as a back map, for example, 2 things happen. First, it appears that the bitmap display is not working at render time. That's an easy fix, but one that you can easily miss. You want to ensure the map used is enabled in the blended box map UI. Second, the map is inverted, which makes sense because of the way it's projected. What you need to do is to make a copy of the map and set the copy's U tiling to -1 to flip it horizontally. The same thing applies to defining a bottom map copied from the top map. The bigger challenge is in the animation itself. Rendered at frame 0, the car looks pretty good. Rendered at any other frame, as the car starts moving and rotating, The effect is funky at best, unacceptable at worst. Again, this is a direct effect of how blended box mapping works, projecting images literally like a movie projector. In the Material Editor, check the blended box map settings again. Note the shy little checkbox that reads Lock to Frame. This is your ticket to a hassle-free solution. Enable this option and specify a frame where the mapping works best. Typically, that would be where the model is aligned with the world, most probably at frame 0, as you probably use that as a base point. Render again at various frames, and notice that the mapping stays uniform throughout. Again, keep in mind that this is a quick solution for easy transforms and does not apply for deformable objects. If that's what you have, then you would need to use a more traditional mapping approach, such as UV unwrapping. In the next movie, you'll learn about what is arguably the coolest feature of blended box mapping, the ability to render templates. This makes it easy to export and process maps in a paint program, and then load them back in 3ds Max for added detail and realism.